This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to find the equation of a polynomial function when you're given the zeros and a point on its graph. So here's the first problem. Find a polynomial p of x with a degree of 3 and zeros at negative 2, 3, and 5, and passing through the point 2, 24. Okay, so we want to find p of x. So p of x is going to equal, let's see, I've got a 0 at negative 2. A 0 at negative 2 means that one of the factors of the polynomial is x plus 2. There's a 0 at 3, so there's another factor, which is x minus 3. And there's a 0 at 5, so the third factor is x minus 5. Now, if we hadn't been told about the point at 2, 24, we could stop right here with what we've got. But since we've got a specific point that this function has to pass through, what I want to do is see if there's going to be a constant, we'll call it a constant which multiplies these three factors. So I want to find out what a might be. I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to take that point, 2, 24, and remember that the 2 is an x value, the 24 is a y value. So I'll take the p of x, which is like a y, and replace that y with 24. So I'll have 24 equals a times, and then instead of these x's, I'm going to write the 2. So it's going to be a times 2 plus 2 times 2 minus 3 times 2 minus 5. Now let's find out what a equals. So this will become 24 equals a times 2 plus 2 is 4, 2 minus 3 is negative 1, and 2 minus 5 is negative 3. Let's multiply those. 4 times negative 1 is negative 4, times negative 3 is positive 12. So I'm going to have 24 equals 12a. I multiply both sides by 12, and I find out that a is equal to 2. So now I can erase this a that I've put in here and just put in a 2. And my polynomial is going to be p of x equals 2 times x plus 2 times x minus 3 times x minus 5. If you want to, or if your teacher wants you to, you could multiply these three factors, the x plus 2 times x minus 3 times x minus 5, and times that constant 2, and you would have the function in a more standard form. Okay, but this answer is also correct. Let's try one more. This one has a multiplicity in it. Find a polynomial p of x with a degree of 4, zeros at negative 2, 1, and 6 with a multiplicity of 2, and passing through 2, -16. Okay, so I want p of x equals, I've got a 0 at negative 2, so one of the factors is going to be x plus 2. I've got a 0 at 1, so there's going to be x minus 1 as a factor, and a 0 at 6, so x minus 6 is a factor, but that is a multiplicity of 2, so I want x minus 6 squared. And I'm given this point 2, -16, so let's put an a in front of these three factors and find out what the constant is going to be, find out what a equals. Okay, the point is 2, -16. So I'm going to say negative 16 equals a times, and then instead of my x's, I'll put in 2's. 2 plus 2 times 2 minus 1 times 2 minus 6 squared. So negative 16 equals a times 2 plus 2 is 4. 2 minus 1 is 1. 2 minus 4, that minus 6 is negative 4. I'm going to square that. So let's see, let's start out by squaring the negative 4. That's going to be positive 16. I'll multiply it by 1, it's still 16. Multiply it by 4, and that becomes 64. So negative 16 equals 64a. I'll divide both sides of this equation by 64, and I'm going to get a equals negative 1/4. So now I know what the constant is. Instead of a, I'll put in negative 1/4. So that means that the function that meets these requirements, that has these zeros and passes through this point, is going to be p of x equals negative 1/4 times x plus 2 times x minus 1 times x minus 6 squared. And once again, if you want to, you could multiply this out. It's all a matter of what you prefer or what your teacher prefers. Okay, so I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.